Glenn says, let me see if I get this right. Here's something that'll make blood shoot right out of your eyes. The Wall Street Journal reports the Obama administration will lend billions of U.S. dollars to Brazil for offshore oil exploration in Brazil. Your tax dollars going to Brazil for drilling that could be done right here in the U.S. Just last year, Obama called offshore drilling, quote, a gimmick. Does he have a handle on how to solve the energy crisis in Washington? Is David Kreutzer, senior policy analyst in energy economics at the Heritage Foundation. Dave, thanks for joining me on the program here.
Thanks
Boy,
for having me.
I got to tell you, you know, we talk. Can you imagine? First of all, can you imagine if George W. Bush loaned $2 billion to a major U.S. oil company in the middle of a recession? People would be up in arms. What is he doing?
Right. Yeah. What is he doing? What's going on in D.C. right now? We're lending billions of dollars to a state oil company when we have private oil companies in the U.S. dying to get access to our own oil and our own offshore reserves. It's crazy.
All right. So we're going to loan $2 billion. I think I have a full screen up here. I asked them to put together a full screen. Here's who we're loaning $2 billion to. Petrobras, the Brazilian oil company. Check it out. Market value of $188 billion, $120 billion in sales. Get this one. The seventh most profitable company in the world, making over $18 billion last year. And by the way, just as a little side footnote, earlier this year, they signed a deal with China to sell up to 58 million barrels a year to China. So here's the thing. Why do they need our $2 billion? Don't we need it here?
Yeah, we could use it here. It just seems silly all the way around. You know, we're giving money from the taxpayers who are trying to fill up their minivans so that we can help a left-of-center government in Brazil avoid using equity from private sources. It's silly. Maybe we're putting helping billionaires top off their bank accounts, but we should be helping minivan drivers fill up their gas tanks.
Hey, good point, Era. We found out the largest holding of George Soros, you remember Soros is the billionaire who was a big backer of the Obama administration, his largest holding in his hedge fund was in fact Petrobras.
Well, I guess we should be happy at least one American's getting something out of the deal, but like I said, I don't think he would be my first choice of the person that needs help.
All right, here's a question. We dug back a little bit and we went back to the campaign when Obama said he had some ideas on how to solve the energy crisis. If I can grab that slide, you guys.
There are things that you can do individually, though, to save energy. Making sure your tires are properly inflated. Simple thing. But we could save all the oil that they're talking about getting off drilling if everybody was just inflating their tires and getting regular tune-ups. You could actually save just as much.
You know, I'm really holding back the laughter right now. I don't mean to laugh at the President of the United States, but
no, I'm with you. I'm thinking
we're going to save billions and billions of dollars, and we're going to solve our energy crisis by filling up our inflating our tires. What about it?
Yeah, I don't know. It seems like it's fodder for the late night talk shows. But we get back to the basic problem. If they think that drilling off the shore of Brazil is a good idea, and if so, I'm with them on that. I don't think we should finance it. But if that's a good idea, it has to be a much better idea to drill offshore in our own waters where we get the revenue. The government doesn't have to pay money. They don't have to lend it to anybody. They get royalty revenues from our own oil companies creating our own jobs here in the U.S. So they've completely given away their argument for any opposition to domestic production of oil. So I'm in favor of that, but it's just silly the way they did it.
You know, and David, I have to assume, let's just say Petrobras discovers more oil with our $2 billion loan, they're just going to sell it to us anyway at market prices, right?
We would hope they would sell some of it to us, but with cap and trade, maybe we're not going to be able to use it anyway. So we might be paying them to develop oil fields so they can sell oil to other countries. Who knows?
All right. Before you go, I want you to stay there real quick. I want to read this, if you don't mind. We have Sarah Palin. We called Sarah Palin's office, and we asked her for a comment on this. And here she directed us to her Facebook website, and it says, quote, Buy American is a wonderful slogan, but you can't say in one breath what you want to do to strengthen our economy and stimulate. And then in another, ship our much-needed dollars to a nation desperate to drill while depriving us of the same opportunity. Would you care to comment on that?
Yeah, I think she's right. I also think you don't have to be lending money to oil companies right now. They're floating in money. That's the first part that doesn't make sense to me. Then you're lending it to the state, the country of Brazil. That also seems silly. So it's silly at a bunch of different levels, and it certainly doesn't fit in with a Buy American, whether you like that or not.
David Kreitzer, you make a great point. David Kreitzer, thanks for joining the program.